brush here is my favorite brush, which is stained Sumi. Not Lax, it's LAX, because it's the airport in LA. Oh, duh. Hopefully, I can also find the cat hair that is plastered to my face somewhere. Not in the eyelashes, that is not sexy. I don't know if that will be cute, but let's do it anyway. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 44, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, 5 looks with the LA Dreams palette from Makeup Obsession. I did an eye swatch video, and at the end of the eye swatch video, I give you my final thoughts on the palette and if it is worth your money. So if you want to know that, just check out that video. Like, this is what she looks like, and yeah, she's dirty, she's used. Timestamps for the different looks will be down in the description box, as will the makeup that I have on my face. This is the last look of the video, and I really, really like it. So without further ado, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes look number one. Around that, and the shimmer I actually want to play with today is this one called Rollerblade, because it's such an interesting shade. I want that on my lid, and I kind of want a pinker goodness in the crease, I think. Let's kind of go for this row then. I know it's the first look, but I don't care. I want to do that today. I'm going to start with the color Bikini. And that is going to go in the crease. Let's tap off a little bit. And the brush I'm using is one from Sigma. It's the E27. Now my base is still a bit tacky, but it looks like the shade does not really care, because it sticks where it needs to stick. And then when I go to blend it out, it wants to blend out, so that is good. But I actually wouldn't have expected any less from Makeup Obsession shadows. Cute, cute, cute. Okay, I'm going to switch brushes and colors. I'm going to go to the color called Beverly Hills, which is a very nice, what's it called again? Bubblegum pink, I think. And I'm just taking small bits at a time. Okay, let's pull in another color. Let's also pull in California Summer, just to blend out the very, very top edge. Ooh, very, very cute. Okay, I'm going to go back to the first brush and the first shade called Bikini, to deepen up or make the crease a little bit more vibrant. And I want it a little bit higher because of the eye shape that I have. I think it is more flattering when I have a little bit more darkness higher up. Ooh, I like this a lot. Do I want a hot pink eye pencil? I don't know yet. I am grabbing my NYX Glitter Primer. Okay, Glitter Primer brush. I'm going to do kind of a faux... They call it a faux cut crease, but it's basically a half cut crease. But instead of using concealer, I'm using my Glitter Primer. I'm first tapping it on, and then I'm kind of carving and cleaning up my eyelid. I need to learn to finish the sentence in one go. And this is a very nice way, especially if you are older, because we don't want to have too much product on our eyelid, because it does not look sexy. It's a very nice way to still get that cut crease or that sharp line effect if you want to. Also the benefit of your shimmer sticking well and not a lot of product. So now I'm going to go to the color called Rollerblade, which is just so, so pretty. Oh yeah. Oh, and it has kind of a greenish shift as well. Oh, this is so pretty. Oh, cool. And then here where I tapped it over the pink, it kind of picks up on that pinkiness that it has there as well. I want a little bit of extra darkness though, but I'm going to go back to the color Bikini first, and then I'll see if I need to darken it up even more. Oh, this is such a pretty shade, guys. It really is kind of a duochrome-y with, or maybe even a multi-chrome-y. It has so many interesting things going on when I look in the mirror. I do want it also a little bit underneath my eye, so let me get a stiff brush. Let me get some of the stuff. Okay, so there's more subtle. I don't have any primer there. And then now it is a little bit more subtle, so let me spray. First I pick up a little bit of eyeshadow, then I spray the brush. Don't go into the shade with a wet brush. Oh yeah, spraying works as well. I'm going to pull it on top of my lashes a little bit. Cute, cute, cute. I kind of want something that complements, and I think I have it, but it is one from Hema, unfortunately, but it is the color that I want, because it's basically that color. So it's this. I hope you can see it. It's maybe a little bit more, I don't know, too blue for what I have in mind. But I'm still going to use it. So yeah, I think this is the color taupe. I don't know. Yeah, that is very, very cute. I have one shade left and it is called Venice Beach. Well, I don't need, technically don't need to use this one, but let's use it anyway. So we had the whole row. Ooh, very cute, very cute. I like this. I'm going to recreate the same on the other eye. Put on liner and mascara and then I will be back to show you the completed look. So hold on tight. Don't go anywhere. Here's the look just before the falsies. That was what I wanted to say. I'm going to put on falsies now. I kind of need to think if I want my spiky ones or my more natural ones. I have not decided yet. I'm also going to choose a lippy, which is probably going to be either a no lip or a very light nude. I have not decided yet, so let me decide all that and then I will be back to show you the final look. Everything is on and here is the completed look. Falsies are from Primark in the style London and the lip combination is a pencil from Catrice in the color Caramel Blonde to Go and then topped off with the Dose of Colors liquid lipstick in Sand and then I get this kind of no lip lip. I do really like it, I feel nice and summery. Let me know down below what you think of this look and let's get ready for the next one. Look number two, I am going to start with a very pale pink, I think, today. I'm going to start with the color California Summer. And the second look is largely going to be the first row, which is kind of wonky. But yeah. So I'm not going to tap off my brush. Because I want the color as vibrant as possible. I think I'm going to use the lighter colors on top of my eye and then maybe the darker green called Palm Trees, the shimmer on the bottom. I'm actually going to go to the color called Smoothie Please, which is this very, very, I don't know, a minty green, but I think it is a satin. So I'm going to grab a shadow packing brush. Let's see what it does. Yeah, it's a satin. Okay, yes, cutesy. I'm going with a smaller brush in the color California Summer, the one that I first used, just to pack it on a little bit more. And then I'm going to go to the color called Vibes. And I'm going to place that in the outer corner. And I'm hoping that because that pink is so very, very pale, that I can blend it into it a little. It seems to be that I can. And basically now I'm working it forward into the crease a bit. And I really like the fact that I can... usually you cannot really blend greens and pinks. Well, you can, but they turn muddy. You can do anything you want, basically. But now it doesn't, and I'm happy about that. I do want that darker green underneath my eye a little bit, but... I'm going to go to the shade called Palm Trees. It's going to go in the center. I'm going to use it dry because I think I can. And yes, I can. And I know I didn't put down a glitter primer. I actually just forgot. I'm going to flip my brush where there's no shadow, or at least I hope so. And I'm going to wiggle here a bit. And here. Palm Trees is going to go on one side and then this shade called smoothie please is going to go on the other side of the brush, so I can kind of mix the two together a bit. Funny thing is that this looks like a very complicated, time-consuming eye look, but actually it took me about 10 minutes. I'm going to place it on top of the darker green to get a little bit of shimmer. Okay, I'm cleaning the brush so I can kind of blend here a bit in the beginning. I think I'm going to do a white pencil because I think that will be fun. Yeah, that's fun. And the pencil is from Revolution. I don't know, it's just called an eye pencil. It's a white one. That's it. I'm going to finish off the look with liner and mascara. Okay, liner and mascara is on, and I'm kind of experimenting with how I place my mascara, because usually I really brush up my lashes, but because I know I'm going to wear falsies, it's actually easier when your lashes are a little bit more facing down. So I'm kind of experimenting with that, so you don't really see my lashes now with the mascara on. So sorry about that, or not, because I know I'm going to wear falsies anyway, which I'm going to put on now. So here is the completed look. I was debating on putting on another lippy because I just put on a gloss before I sat down to, before I put on my camera. But I kind of like the gloss. It is one from Lux in, I don't know the color, 1851, I believe. But it looks like this. It's just a pinky one with some shimmer in it. I got this one in a style tone box. I don't use it often, but I think it is kind of cute. Let me know down below what you think of this look, and let's get ready for the next one. Look number 3. Yes, I had to think. I'm going to do something there. I have a combination in my head that I want to use. So let's start with the color called Surfs Up. I'm going to start here in the beginning of my eye. My eye base is still a bit tacky, so that's why I'm tapping it on. Okay, cleaning the brush on a towel, and then I'm going to blend the edge. Dipping into that green a tiny bit, just with the tip of the brush, just to make sure that I can get it blend on the edge. Okay. Then I'm going to go to the color called Lax, or LAX. I'm placing this very low because I kind of want to blend it up and in. But I don't want it very, very dark just yet. Now I'm going to use the tip of this brush to work the color in. It's barely noticeable when I do this. You can't really see it, but when I look forward, I can see that there is a hint of that darker color, and that is good. Brush, and I'm going to go back to the first color called Surfs Up. Just going to place it a little bit on the outer edge, but a little bit higher, so that the shape that I have kind of goes the way that I want it. Okay, I want a little bit of a nicer blend, so I'm grabbing face powder to get a nice soft blend without dragging it up too high. So I think I'm going to drag the color Surfs Up onto my lid as well. And that was the first color, so I'm just going to put that on my lid as a base, a greener base. And then the color LAX a little bit on the outside. I'm being a bit messy, because I kind of want to, oh, this is very cute, but I kind of want to cover it up anyway. So I have my primer. I'm going to do this on my hand so that it kind of coats the bristles already, and then I'm going to tap on my eye instead of swipe. I still want to be kind of precise. I could theoretically carve out just a tiny piece. Maybe that's fun. Grabbing a little bit of extra primer just for the tips, so that I kind of clean up a little bit, but not a lot. Okay, now I'm going to go to the color called Rollerblade. And I know that I've used it in the first, or I don't know, second look, I don't know. But I kind of want to play with the green in it today. So I'm going to put it on, oh, that's so pretty. Here, and then I'm also going to put it on top of the part where I cleaned up the glitter primer. Or I cleaned up the shadow. Then I'm going to go to the color called Road Trip, which is the darkest of the shimmer green. It's going to go on the outside corner. And then in the middle I'm going to swipe, then flip the brush and swipe. So basically I have both shades and I'm swipe mixing them. That's weird English, but I don't care. Cute, very very cute. So I'm going to go to the shade called Smoothie Please, which is the minty, because I wanted that in the inner corner. And apparently underneath my eye a little bit as well. Does it go with everything? Probably not. But then again, maybe it does, so that's fun. Shall I then? Nah. Okay, let's finish off the lower lash line on one side. Let me get a small... Yeah, let me get you. I'm going to go to the color called Surf's Up. Yes, and then I'm going to go to the color Smoothie Please that I have in the inner corner, and I'm going to drag it a little bit more on top. Yeah, that is cute. Let me do that on the other eye too. Put on some liner and mascara, and then I will be back to show you the look just before the falsies. Hopefully I can also find the cat hair that is plastered to my face somewhere. So hold on tight, I'll be right back. Here's the look just before the falsies. And I already put on a lippy. It is a Revolution cream in the color Hustle. And I love this color now so, so much. Maybe I need to get a backup. I don't know. Let me put on falsies. Falsies on. Here is the completed look. I like it. The falsies I have on are from Catrice. They are in the style hashtag InstaVolume. And they are... Well, basically like the Ardell Demi Wispies, but better. That is it for look number 3. Let me know down below what you think of this look. And let's get ready for look number 4. Okie dokie, look number 4. And I am in a pink mood. So that's what I'm... That's what we are going to do today. Oh yeah, the washing machine is on. I also changed my mic where it is placed, so I hope that the sound is good. But I am going to start with... I think I'm going to start with the color Beverly Hills. I haven't set the base. I'm going to do that with this shade. So that's why I'm tapping it on my eye. Let's go next to the color called Sunset, which is more of a, stay in there, a bluer pink. Swirling it in the crease sounds funky. I don't know if that's a good funky though. And it also goes underneath my eye, but because this brush is smaller, it's also a little bit higher placed. I don't think that was good English. I'm going to go to the color called Hollywood Boulevard. Which is... I don't know if it's darker than the one that I'm using now. That I have just used, to be quite honest, because the tones are different. It is giving me more depth, but not specifically darkness, which is okay. Okay, let's go back to the first brush. don't have any extra product on here. Cool.
Yuki.
I think we are ready for the shimmers. So let me get my primer that I have in front of me. Wow, I was prepared. And a brush. I'm going to put the shimmer primer on my eyelid, as I have been doing throughout the entire video. Not in the eyelashes, that is not sexy. Okay. I'm going to go to the color LA Dreams first, which, if I am not mistaken, is also a duochrome shade. I'm not going to bring this all the way in though. Cutesy, cutesy. I'm cleaning my brush a tiny bit. Yes. Then I'm going to go to the color called Fame, which is more of a, I don't know, bubblegummy frosty pink. I don't know. It's going to go in the inner corner. Yeah, it's more frosty. I'm going to swipe it over that first shade a tiny bit, just dragging it over. To get them to blend a little bit better. It's almost like the inner one has a frosty pink shift and then the other one is more, I don't know, peachy. It's such a unique, I don't even think it will show on camera. It is just so, so unique. Let me get the color called Hollywood Boulevard, I think. No, let's get the color Beverly Hills, this one. And that's going to go in the inner part of my eye. Okay, eye pencil. I have a pink here. Do I have another pink? Yes, I do. I have a pink there, I don't think so. Let's see which one I want. Okay. So I want this one, which is from Essence in the color Life in Pink. Okay, and I think I want the duochrome shade there. So I'm going to go back to the color called LA Dreams. And I'm going to put it on top. Now this is a little bit of a bigger brush. It's more of a blending brush, but that's okay. It's the firm Precision Firm Blender from Sigma. But I kind of like it that way. I don't know what I wanted to say. Okay, and then that frosty pink called Fame is going to go in the inner. Do I like that? I think I do. Oh no, my battery is flashing. Oh no. This is the eye look so far. Let me put on liner and mascara, change the battery, and then I will be right back before the falsies. Liner and mascara is on, and here's the look just before the falsies. Let me put on the falsies, choose a lippy, and then I will be right back to show you the completed look. Everything is on, here is the completed look. Nice and hot pink. I like it. The lippy I have paired it with is one from NYX. It is a Dazed and Diffused Blurring Lipstick in the color My Goodies, which has a brush on one side and it's basically, yeah, a pencil on the other. And I really, really like this formula. I love the color as well. The falsies I have on are, I think, the most dramatic ones that I still have left in my collection, which are in the style Milan from Primark. And then this is going to be my final form today. I want to say look, but we still have one look coming in this video. Let me know down below what you think of this look. And, well, let's get ready for the last look then. The last look of the video, and I kind of wanted to do a two-tone look today. So, yeah, let's hope that I can kind of make that happen, but in a short time, otherwise the video will be too long. But what else is new? I'm going to start with the color called, let's start with Beverly Hills. And basically the idea is one pink crease, the other one a green, and then on the lid I will use the same shimmer on both eyes, if that makes any sense. Starting in the color Beverly Hills, tapping it on my eye because I haven't set the base. And then when I feel I can blend, I will blend a bit. And basically the idea is to kind of get the same depth of tone. So now I'm going to go to the other eye. I have one of the same brushes. It's Morphe 510, not my favorite, but I have two of those. I'm going to go to the color Surfs Up. And I'm basically going to do the same thing as I did on that eye. Let's grab the color Bikini, which is a little bit maybe richer. It's also a little bit bluer, so maybe that will kind of complement the green a little bit better. The same brush that I just used for the pink. Because yeah, it's pink, so as long as I don't kind of mix the green and the pink brushes, I'm good. Yeah, I think this is a bit better. Side, and I think I'm going to go into the shade Sunset. I'm kind of searching between these, but I think I'm going to grab this one first and then lightly to deepen up the crease. And I'm also going to bring that down so I can basically start from the lower lash line up to get the shape that I want. And then I'm looking forward so that I can kind of know where I want everything to be. Need to learn to finish the sentence. Wow, that was quick. And then on the other side, I'm going to grab the E25 from Sigma, which is the same but bigger. And I'm going to go to the color called Vibes. Same process. Inside, I'm going to go to the color LAX with a small brush. This is one of the Morphe, this is the 506, and then for the other eye I will use the 507. I'm going to concentrate this in the outer corner and in the crease again. I'm also going to run it underneath a little bit, just to blend everything out, blow it a bit up. I don't know what I'm going to say, what I'm saying, but you see what I'm doing. So let's, the other eye, I'm now going to go to the color called Hollywood Boulevard, and if that is not dark enough, I will actually pull in the color LAX on this eye as well. I kind of mix them together on my arm, and it works. Especially if I use this shade, the Hollywood Boulevard, first. So that one actually mixes quite nicely with the LAX. You get a very nice deep dark blend without it turning overly muddy. And I actually think I'm going to do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go with the pink brush that I have now, the shade Hollywood Boulevard. I'm going to go on top of the green here. And then on my other eye, I will do the same thing, but in reverse. So I will there go in with that darker green called LAX. Very nice. I like this mix of color, actually. Gives it a little bit of extra oomph and a little bit of extra dimension. A little bit of extra darkness. I'm going to go back to the previous brush. I'm just going to make sure that the blends are nice now. Okay, then with the brush that I used for the green, I'm going to go back into the color LAX just a tiny bit for this side here. I'm going to build it up slowly because I don't really want to lose a lot of the pink, but I just want to give it that extra depth that I have there. And I'm dipping in constantly, but just with the tips, very, very lightly. Not a lot of pressure on the brush. Now I'm going to go back to that Sigma brush and the color Hollywood Boulevard that I used before I put down the green. And I'm going to go over it, so I'm kind of going to sandwich it in between. Then I'm going to go back to the color called Hollywood Boulevard. I'm going to tap that over on both corners. Okay. NYX Glitter Primer. Shimmer time. I'm grabbing my NYX Glitter Primer and the flat brush. And I'm going to carve out a half cut crease. Okay. Then I'm going to go to the color called Venice Beach. And that is going to go on top. Okay, then I'm just taking one of the Morphe brushes and I'm just going to blend here in the outer corner of both eyes. Yeah, I actually think I do. Let's use this one. It's maybe a bit more golden, but that's okay. I'm grabbing a very, very small brush and the color called Venice Beach again. And I'm going to press it on top of the pencil that I just put down. Let's grab the color called Fame. I don't know if this will be fun what I'm about to do though, but let's see. And then the color called Smoothie, please. Oh, this is not a good idea, I think. Let's grab the color Fame and put it here as well. Let's get the color Venice Beach and put it over because what I intended. Yeah. It does not really translate, but that's okay. This is the look so far. I'm going to put on liner and mascara. Here's the look just before the falsies, which I'm going to put on now. So when you will next see me, the look will be all complete and we can close off the video. Everything is on and here is the completed look. I really like how it turned out. It has been a hot minute since I have done a two-toned look and I'm very happy that I did. This was it for this video. 5 looks with the LA Dreams palette from Makeup Obsession. Let me know down below if you have a favorite look. Let me know if you have the palette and don't forget to check out the eye swatch video where also the review part is at the end of that video. That was a very weird sentence. But yeah. The makeup that I have on my face will be listed down in the description box. I will list or tell you the lippy that I have on. It's a Generation Matte from Catrice with the black cap in the color Muddy Madness, which is, I think, I don't know, is it a neutral brown? I don't know, but I think it complements both colors very nicely and it balances everything out a little bit more. This was it. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. Stay safe, stay healthy, try to stay sane, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.